Wigginson here. So I got this Chinese off-brand secondhand GT1030 for $35. I got lucky for it, the card was in pristine condition, already repasted complete with the box. I have done a bit of research before doing this, so I would like to share the knowledge with you. Mind you, I'm no expert in this field, so I apologize in advance for any misinformation or lack thereof. First, make sure that you meet the following requirements to have a second GPU for physics. Enough power supply headroom, 50 to 100 watts spare is alright, depends on the GPU. Second, PCIe X16 slot. It doesn't have to be fast, PCIe 3.0 with X4 lanes will do, just make sure that it fits. Enough space between your main GPU and bottom case. I had to remove 3 bottom intake fans for this, which makes me realize they were kind of redundant. And last but not least, decent airflow. Single intake and outtake is enough, I suppose. P6 alone is very light on the GPU. The installation is very simple. Just plug the card to the second PCIe slot, plug the HDMI to the main GPU, install the latest compatible driver, set P6 to second GPU, that's pretty much everything. You don't need a beefy card for P6, just make sure it's not too old or too weak. Here are the Nvidia card's criteria that I would recommend for P6. Just make sure it's affordable, requires low consumption, having a Maxwell architecture or above for better physics computation, small, doesn't require any pin, and compatible with your setup. And here are the recommended products based on above criteria. I would suggest you to get a GT1030 for a cheap card with a decent architecture for physics. It has the lowest power consumption of all. I personally use it and it runs physics so well with no noticeable impact on performance. If money isn't an issue, get a GTX 1650 or RTX 3050 as the longer driver support will benefit you in the long run. This is the list of problems that I've encountered after installing second GPU. If you face any crash or incompatibility after installing the second GPU, simply open Device Manager, Display Adapter, and disable your second GPU. Reportedly, Nvidia aimed to end driver support for Maxwell and Pascal starting from October 2025. GTX 16 series and above will still be supported. This will not be a problem if you have an AMD as the main card, as the available driver will do just fine. But if you have the latest Nvidia card as your main GPU, you might face driver incompatibilities later on, as Nvidia doesn't allow two separate driver versions to be installed in a single OS. There's probably a workaround for this, but your safest bet is to get at least a GTX 16 series or above. In Cyberpunk 2077, if you have an AMD as primary card, you may see this error. Use this comment without the quotation. Put it in the Steam Launch option. On GOG, just follow this guide. If you want to use ray tracing, then disable the second GPU and delete the command line. In Just Cause 2, you might face this crash. Use this comment on the launch parameter. If you can't see water simulation option, choose your secondary card as primary GPU, then launch the game. Beware of optimal performance though, especially if you use low-end GPU. In Batman Arkham Knight, you can enable all the physics effects except the smoke. You can turn it on in the setting, but you won't see any of the effects coming out. This is a lost cause. All you can do is turn off the effects and be content with the vanilla smoke. Let's say you already have it installed and want to try out some games. There are dozens of games that utilize hardware accelerated physics. Here's the list of some of the popular ones. Let's take a look at the benchmark. We'll be right back.
Get out of that building, Chase. Move. Squad swarming on you, Faith. Find a way out of there. Should be an exit through the accounting office.
So yeah, I hope you find this video useful, and thank you for watching.